Jimmy, welcome.
Hey guys, how are you?
Well, we're better than you by the sounds of it. How are you going?
Yeah, but, you know, in a lot of pain at the moment, but I'm okay. I'm good. You know, I'm glad to get it fixed. It's one of those things where it's been a long time coming. You know, it's sort of 50 years of wear and tear, you know, jumping off of PA stacks and swinging off of lightning trusses and falling off horses in film clips. Yeah, you know, all the I should have been in a Paul Kelly film clip. I did all the dumb things, you know.
How hard was it for you to make the call?
You know, very difficult. You know, I had all these shows booked for, you know, you book them 6 months in advance, 12 months in advance. And, you know, it's a pet hate. I really hate to let people down, and not only punters, but also promoters, you know. So, about 2 months ago, I started getting really bad pain, and I've been sort of struggling with it ever since. And it's just got to the point where it's almost unbearable. I can hardly walk. So, you know, I thought, well, if it's going to get to the point where it affects the quality of the show I'm doing, then I've got to pull the plug so that I can get it fixed and get on and do shows like next year.
One of my favourite prophets, Shakira, said, "The hips don't lie, Jimmy." And, and it's not also about your concerts.
My hips have been lying for years.
But it's not just about concerts. It's also about life, isn't it, Jimmy? You want to be as fit and healthy as you can be for your own life.
Oh, I mean everything. Music's part of my life. It's everything. But I mean, I just, you know, it's one of those things where I've had back problems for about 8 years. I had surgery about 8 years ago, and it never really fixed everything. And it sort of affected my hips and my lower back. And I just figure if I don't do it now, it really will affect me long term. So I'd rather get it done, take the time off, bite the bullet, take the time off, and then come back, you know, ready to jump off PA stacks again.
Well, I mean, you mentioned that your crazy stage antics have contributed to this and taken the toll. Could it be time just to release, just go strip back some ballads, you doing an unplug, this just like, let's strip right back, Jimmy?
Well, what about a Christmas record?
Hey, you can still play it.
Nice segue. Listen, I listen, it could be a nice time. You know, I'm pretty happy to do any sort of record. So I like making, you know, I'll make a crooner's record. I've been taught, actually, Neil Finn was out here just touring with Crowded House. And Neil and I, you know, we laugh and talk about it. He said he wants to produce a song, an album with me just crooning. And I said, you write the songs and I'll do it. So we've got that on the horizon somewhere, yeah.
Well, we saw what you did with Soul Deep. We know that you've got range, mate, and I look forward to that crooning thing. But we should point out, you've still got a show to do, right? So, like, it's this weekend, your last show in Adelaide, and I'm just wondering what the headspace is here. Do you just say, well, I've got to be cautious, I'm about to go into surgery, or do you go, you know what,
hips,
I'm about to get all this replaced, let's just blow this out?
You know, Molly, have you seen me dance? It doesn't really, even if my hips fell apart on the show, nobody would notice. but no, it's one of those things where I've had to take it easy this whole week because I just, you know, obviously I want to get up there and be able to, you know, give everything. And to tell you the truth, I think I'm probably going to get through the show. It's the Velo, you know, Adelaide 500, a big, 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 big show. Adelaide's my hometown. And I think the adrenaline of playing in my hometown and on such a big show is going to carry me through it. But you know, it's going to be a great show anyway. But I might, you know, let's face it, if I'm in a lot of pain, there could be a lot more screaming than usual. Who's going to notice?
And also, the crowd would pick you up and carry you, Jimmy Barnes.
Absolutely. You know, and I'm not relying on them to do that, but of course they will. Yeah.
Hey, how confident are you that you'll be storming the stage again in the second half of next year?
Oh, absolutely. They tell me I need a good, you know, 3 months off and, you know, and maybe a few months physio. But it's not, I'm not the first person to have this surgery. It's been done a lot, so scraping your hip and replacing it and doing all sorts of other things to it. So I'm pretty sure that, you know, I think the hardest bit is going to be keeping me sitting still for 3 months. I'm hyperactive. You know, I'll probably, in that time, my plans are to write a new rock and roll record and also to finish writing a book. So, I figure if that should keep me busy for the first 2 weeks.
And also to release Walking Class Man.
Oh, very good.
I see where you're coming from. They're very good. Yeah. But my wife said I should do a hip-hop album.
Okay, we've officially exhausted all the puns we are allowed on the show.
No, I'm sorry. These are dad jokes.
You mentioned the you might do a Christmas album. By total coincidence, we have your new Christmas album. I mean, it's extraordinary. How did that happen?
You know what? I'll tell you exactly how it happened. I've just spent, like, you know, 2.5 years singing at home with my wife for social media. And during the process, I sang all these songs I'd never sing, you know, in my career. I've never sang, you know, I've sang Doris Day songs, for Christ's sake. But I found all these tones and these registers that I really didn't normally use. I found my falsetto voice, which is actually pretty smooth, and a lot of my lower register that I hadn't used before. So I figured, since I've discovered these new tones, I might as well use them. And it was a great time to make a Christmas record.
Oh, my gosh, and imagine having Jimmy in your house on Christmas Day. What a beautiful idea. Jimmy, talk to me about your family Christmases. Obviously, they look beautiful now. Have they always been a happy time?
Oh, you know, obviously, when I was a young fella, it was tough, you know, like a lot of people out there, you know, who are living below the poverty line, you know, it brought a whole new range of pressures onto our parents and onto us kids, you know, just to see our parents struggling, trying to live up to what we thought Christmas was supposed to be was heartbreaking. But you know, but it was at the same time, you know, when you're a kid, you think everybody's the same, so you don't really know. You know, I just knew that it was hard on them. But what I did like about Christmas even then was the fact that, you know, my parents, who were fighting for a lot of our lives, would actually try and smile at each other for a while. And it seems Christmas seems to bring out the best in people, even if it's only for a few days. So that's Christmas has always been one of my favorite times of year. And the other thing was, even though we didn't have a lot when we were young, one of the things that really brought us together as a family was singing. We'd sing Christmas carols, right? My dad would sing some of the songs on this record, and my mum. And my brothers and sisters and I would go around and sing at the neighbours, and they'd throw things at us.
Well, it's a beautiful backstory to this album. That is the album, Jimmy Barnes' Blue Christmas. By the way, Jimmy, I have to point out, thanks for signing that for us, but that is the worst signature I've ever seen.
But you know what? Yeah, if you sign 5,000 of them, by the end of it, it looks like a straight line.
Oh, Jimmy, thanks so much. Hey, good luck with the surgery and stuff too.
Yeah, indeed.
Nice to talk to you guys. Merry Christmas, all of you.